Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at different ways you can organize your apps in iOS. So let's look at all the different ways that you can organize your apps on a device like the iPad. So here I've got four different app screens, and you can see the dots at the bottom, and it shows me which screen I'm on, and I can flip through them very easily. Now within any screen, I can reorder what's there. I do that by tapping and holding any of the app icons I see, and after a couple seconds you can see they all start jiggling. Most of them have little X's next to them so I can delete them, but also the one that I'm currently have my finger on I can move around and put it in a different order. Now of course I've got my iPad in horizontal mode. If I do it in vertical mode, they'll be in the same order with pages first, number second, keynote third, but they will not be 5x4, but instead be 4x5. So don't worry too much about like trying to put one in the upper right hand corner or the lower left hand corner, because they won't always be that way depending upon the orientation of your iPad. However, you still get them in the same order from the first one in the upper left to the last one in the lower right. Now as long as everything is still active here, I can take any app I want and move it to another screen, or I can actually just flip to another screen. I'm going to swipe right to left, and you can see I go to the other screen, everything's still active and I can still move things around. So I can get around on all my screens and arrange the app icons on those screens like I want. But I can grab one, so let me grab say the Kindle app here, and if I drag to the right it will go to this next screen here, this page of my home screen, and I can drop it there. So you can easily move apps back and forth. I'm going to drag this to the left between the screens. And that's how you can arrange them. And you can make screens or pages that have apps that are similar. For instance, you can put a lot of work-oriented apps on one page and then put games on another page, entertainment apps on another page, etc. So you can organize them that way. Now we have app folders, which are probably the biggest tool we can use to organize things. So for instance, say I want to put pages, numbers, and keynote together in one app folder. I simply take one of them, I'll take numbers, and I move it on top of pages and I release. And it creates this app folder here. It gives it a name based on the categories of the app. So in this case, it notices that both are productivity and they get that folder name from that. But I can select the folder name and change it to whatever I want. And then I can tap outside of that, and you can see I've got the app folder there. If I want to move something else into it, I can simply drag it into it. If I'm going to move something out of it, I tap inside and I can drag out and then position on that screen like I want. Now these folders can have multiple pages inside them. So for instance, here's a folder and you can see there's four dots there, and I can move between those and see different apps in those. So I can also drag and go to a different page inside the app folder. So I can organize things inside these app folders. I can't have other folders inside of folders, but at least I have these pages and I can organize inside them. To leave this, I'll just tap outside, and you can see it takes me outside there. To get rid of an app folder, you simply drag everything out. When you drag the last one out, the app folder itself disappears. And you can drag the app folders themselves very easily and reposition them on the page, or take them to another page of your home screen as well. Now even with some really good organization, having some good app folders and having my pages kind of organized by the type of app that's there, it still can be hard to find apps, especially if you have a lot of them. So I rarely actually look for a specific app deep inside of a folder. Instead, I will simply search for it. So I'm going to hit the home button here to stop everything from moving. So now everything's kind of static. I can't move things around or delete apps. And I'm just going to swipe down in the middle of the screen and do a spotlight search. And one of the things I'll get from a spotlight search are apps. So right away, just by typing a couple of characters, I see applications and even a top hit there, which is an application that I've launched many times. It's one of my own games, and I can quickly find that app. And you can see it's much quicker for me to actually do that than going and looking through the different screens, then looking through the different app folders to try to find that app. So I don't really worry about throwing lots of apps into folders. If I'm not going to be using them that often, I'll just do a spotlight search and launch the app that way rather than having to find out where it is in my iPad interface. Now don't forget about the bottom row. Some people call it the dock because it's like the Mac dock. You can fit up to 6 apps here on the iPad, less on the iPhone, just 4. But you can put important things there. So if you find yourself using something a lot, you can just move it down there. And now notice that any screen I'm on, I have access to those apps. In addition, what's really cool is you can put app folders there. So for instance, I can put this app folder down here. It's available on any screen I want, and I can quickly access all those apps in there. So you can imagine some people would like to just fill the entire bottom with app folders, just have one screen of apps per app folder. Tap it and you have access to 9 apps. So you can have 9 times 6 here on the bottom of the iPad for a quick and easy access. So one last tip I've got is to look at how other people have organized their apps. If you have friends and family members that have iPads and iPhones, every once in a while exchange them and take a look how each of you organizes your apps differently. This gives you some good ideas. For instance, I did this recently and got the idea of going to these app folders, and since you can name them whatever you want, it was very easy for me to simply add emoji as some of the different things that are here. So for instance, you can just add a little graphic there like that, and now you can see it appears and makes that folder stand out a little more.